Hello and welcome to Compline for the Monday of Holy Week. We're not able to do things in our usual way in church this year for obvious reasons, and I hope that Compline said with me and my rectory, you in your homes will be an acceptable alternative. You'll find the text for the service underneath the description box beneath the video in YouTube, and it'll also appear in the description box on Facebook. However, some of you may already have your copies of Compline from last year. It's available as a download from the pages on the church near you. The psalm for Compline is the same every day at this time. So instead of saying it all every night, I've decided to break it up into three sections for Monday, Tuesday and Wednesday. So the psalmody today will be 139 verses 1 to 6. The Lord Almighty grant us a quiet night and a perfect end. Amen. Our help is in the name of the Lord, who made heaven and earth. So we reflect in silence on the past day, those opportunities we have had to meet God in our homes, in people we may have met, those instances perhaps when we were so preoccupied God seemed completely absent and we were utterly unaware of God. Most merciful God, we confess to you before the whole company of heaven and one another that we have sinned in thought, word and deed, and in what we have failed to do. Forgive us our sins, heal us by your Spirit, and raise us to new life in Christ. Amen. O God, make speed to save us. O Lord, make haste to help us. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be for ever. Amen. Before the ending of the day, Creator of the world, we pray that you with steadfast love would keep your watch around us while we sleep. From evil dreams defend our sight, from fears and terrors of the night. Tread underfoot our deadly foe, that we no sinful thought may know. O Father, that we ask be done, through Jesus Christ, your only Son, and Holy Spirit, by whose breath our souls are raised to life from death. Psalm 139, verses 1 to 6. O Lord, you have searched me out and known me. You know when I sit down and when I rise up. You discern my thoughts from far away. You search out my path and my lying down, and are acquainted with all my ways. Even before a word is on my tongue, O Lord, you know it completely. You hem me in, behind and before, and lay your hand upon me. Such knowledge is too wonderful for me. It is so high that I cannot attain it. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be for ever. Amen. The night prayer, the readings are the same every night, so instead we're going to have the New Testament lesson from evening prayer, which tonight comes from St. Paul's letter to the Colossians, the first chapter, beginning at the 18th verse. He is the head of the body, the church. He is the beginning, the firstborn from the dead, so that he might come to have first place in everything. For in him all the fullness of God was pleased to dwell, And through him, God was pleased to reconcile to himself all things, whether on earth or in heaven, by making peace through the blood of his cross. And you, who were once estranged and hostile in mind, doing evil deeds, he has now reconciled in his fleshly body through death, so as to present you holy and blameless and irreproachable before him, provided that you continue securely established and steadfast in the faith, without shifting from the hope promised by the gospel that you heard, which has been proclaimed to every creature under heaven. I, Paul, became a servant of this gospel. Just a few words of reflection on that lection. The image, the metaphor of the body is very well known in Paul's writing. Elsewhere, he describes the members of the body being of equal importance. The eye doesn't have any more importance than a leg or a hand. We're an integrated whole. And Paul uses the physical body as this metaphor, yet also we know that Paul sometimes has reservations about the physical world if we lead our lives according to the physical, selfish, fleshly principles. We need to rejoice in our bodies because we need to look after them and we believe that our soul indwells in them. But he says something very, very interesting about Jesus, does he not? For in him all the fullness of God was pleased to dwell. We're reminded that Jesus Christ is fully human and Jesus Christ is fully divine. But it seems to me that so often we're obsessed with becoming divine, becoming holy and perfect, we forget what it is to be fully human. And the only person who is fully human is Jesus Christ. So all the time we need to balance those things that we know the world places on us in terms of pressures and not to cave into those, mindful always of our separate, holy, blessed calling. And it's this physical body which is to break and to die. It is that seed that falls into the earth and dies and then grows and is so fruitful. So this week, a little bit of us dies, a little bit of us dies on Good Friday as we commemorate that necessary suffering on the cross for our redemption, by which all the bad things that humankind has done is redeemed, is brought back, is bought back by our Lord and Saviour Jesus Christ. The Responsory. Into your hands, O Lord, I commend my spirit. Into your hands, O Lord, I commend my spirit. For you have redeemed me, Lord God of truth. I commend my spirit. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Into your hands, O Lord, I commend my spirit. Keep me as the apple of your eye. Hide me under the shadow of your wings. Save us, O Lord, while waking, and guard us while sleeping, that awake we may watch with Christ, and asleep may rest in peace. Now, Lord, you let your servant go in peace. Your word has been fulfilled. My own eyes have seen the salvation which you have prepared in the sight of every people, a light to reveal you to the nations, and the glory of your people Israel. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be for ever. Amen. Save us, O Lord, while waking, and guard us while sleeping, that awake we may watch with Christ, and asleep may rest in peace. At this point, we offer prayers, intercessions, prayers, thanksgiving for the day, about our concerns, and maybe for the morrow. Visit our homes, O Lord, we pray, and drive far from them the snares of the enemy. May your holy angels dwell with us and guard us in peace, and may your blessing be always upon us, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. In peace we will lie down and sleep, for you alone, Lord, make us dwell in safety. Abide with us, Lord Jesus, for the night is at hand and the day is now past. As the night watch looks for the morning, so do we look for you, O Christ. The Lord bless us and watch over us. The Lord make his face shine upon us and be gracious to us. The Lord look kindly on us and give us peace. Amen. And I look forward to our being with one another tomorrow evening when we continue our journey through Psalm 139. I wish you a very good evening.